Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Karuna teaching the course Computer Architecture and Organization. Second unit contains the following topics: machine instruction and program, instruction and instruction sequence, in which we discussed about different types of instructions and their notations. And also we have concentrated on basic input-output operations, and also we discussed about the role of stacks and queues in computer program. In this video, we will concentrate on logic, shift and rotate instructions. Later we will discuss about ARM processor, in which we will discuss about arithmetic and logic instructions, branch instruction. Then also we will see what are the different types of addressing modes to calculate address of the data. Outcome of this topic: after completion of this topic, you can understand how the processor performs logic, shift and rotate instructions, and also you can explain logic, shift, rotate instructions. Let us see. First, logic instructions. To perform logic operations, both hardware and software required. Okay, so in case of hardware, different types of logic gates are present. Okay, so with the help of these different logic gates, we can perform logic operations. And also to perform logic operations, software also required. Okay, software nothing but program. Program nothing but set of instructions. Let us see what are the instructions are used to perform logical operations one by one. These are the logic instructions, in which let us discuss one by one. Okay, so for example, AND instruction. First, let us discuss AND instruction. Let us see, syntax of this AND is AND source comma destination. Okay, let us take example AND R0 comma R1. Okay, so R0, R1 are the processor registers which contains the bits. These logic instructions are used to perform bit manipulated operations. Okay, so let us take for example R0 having 4 bit data and R1 also 4 bit data. Okay, so for example R0 is 0010. Okay, R1 is 0011. Okay, perform AND operation between these two. So here in case of AND operation, any one of the input is 0, then output is 0. If both inputs are 11, then output is 1. If both inputs are 00, then output is 0. Okay, so after performing this AND operation, output will be stored in destination. That is, here R1 is the destination. Okay, so output will be stored in destination R1. Likewise, this AND instruction used to perform AND operation between the two operands. Those are source operand and destination operand. Okay, likewise OR operation. Let us see OR operation. OR syntax for this OR operation is OR source comma destination. Okay, this instruction perform operation between source operand and destination operand bits. Okay, so here for example, let us take R, R0 comma R1. Okay, so R0 is the source, R1 is the destination register. Okay, so those two are processor registers. Okay, so here let us take 0010 R1 0011. Okay, so perform OR operation between the bits of two operands. Okay, so any one of the input is 1, the output is 1 in case of OR operation. If the two inputs are 1 1, then output is 1, otherwise 0 0. So this output, again these two are inputs, this is output. Output will be transferred to destination, that is R1. Let us concentrate on NOT operation. So NOT, here the syntax of this NOT is destination. Syntax of NOT is destination, NOT destination. So here let us take NOT R0. Destination register is R0. If you take R0 is just, this is 4 bit data, then R0 equal to 0010. Example, R0 equal to 0010. Okay, this instruction performs 1's complement of that number. Okay, so here this becomes, after performing NOT operation, this becomes 1, this 1, and 0 1. Okay, so we can say it as 1's complement. 1's complement. Okay, so NOT operation is used to perform 1's complement of the operand. Okay, so again output will be stored in destination only. Okay, so R0 is destination only. Okay, with the help of NOT instruction, 2's complement can also be performed. Okay, what is 2's complement? After performing 1's complement, if you add 1 to the 1's complement, then you will get 2's complement of that number. Okay, so for example, here 0011. Example, 00 is plus 3. I am taking 4 bit data. Okay, so plus 3. So perform, what is the 1's complement? So for example, here to perform 2's complement, we require NOT, R0, and then you need to add 1 to the 1's complement. Okay, so after performing NOT operation, output will be stored in destination. Okay, and then add instruction adds source operand to the destination content R0. R0 is having 1's complement. Okay, so this add instruction adds source operand 1 to the content of R0, that is 1's complement of that number. Okay, so let us see. For example, here 0011 is the plus 3 4 bit data, NOT destination. That means here NOT destination register is R0. Okay, R0 contains 0011. Okay, after performing NOT operation, okay, so R0 becomes 1100. Okay, then with the help of add instruction, okay, add plus 1, plus 1, then you will get 1011. This becomes minus 3. This is the 2's complement. Okay, minus 3 nothing but 2's complement of 3. Okay, so to perform 2's complement operation, we use NOT operation and add instruction. Okay, NOT instruction and add instruction. In some computers, to perform 2's complement, single instruction also can be used, that is negate R0. Okay, so negate R0, this is destination. Okay, so negate performs two's complement of the content present in R naught. Again, after performing two's complement, output will be stored in R naught only. Okay, now let us see some set of instructions. Those are AND, COMPARE, BRANCH. Okay, so here AND operation, this AND operation performs AND operation between source and destination. Okay, so now let us take R naught is 5A. 5A nothing but 010 and 1010. Okay, perform AND operation between source operand, okay, and destination operand. Source operand is FF, 111111. Okay, perform AND operation between these two. Okay, so the output is 0101 1010. Okay, so 5A. Okay, so any number is AND with the F, then you will get same number. Okay, so this transfer to R naught. Okay, now compare instruction compares whether R naught content is same as 5A. Okay, now R naught content is 5A, that means 0. Okay, carry flag will be set to 0, then processor jumps to if 0. Okay, if the two numbers are matched, okay, so R naught content is 5A, then that is matched with 5A. Okay, that's what these two are same, that means equal to 0, then processor jump to the specified location S. So that means specified location labeled as S. Okay, otherwise execute next instruction. Likewise, in such cases AND operations are used, or we can say logic operations are used. Now let us concentrate on shift instructions. Some operations are required that the bits of operand is shifted to left or right by the specified number of times in the count. Okay, that count may be specified in the instruction immediately or specified in the processor register. Okay, let us see one by one. Here shift instruction, different types of shift instructions are there. Okay, so logical shift and arithmetic shift. Okay, arithmetic shift. Under logical shift, we have logical left shift and right shift. Okay, under which left shift and right shift. Okay, arithmetic left shift and right shift. Okay, so we will discuss about all these kinds of shift operations. Now let us concentrate on logical shift left. Okay, the syntax for this logical shift left: count, comma, destination. Okay, so that count may be specified in the instruction immediately, that means L shift left hash 1 comma destination may be R naught, or that instruction is used to perform only one shift operation. Okay, let us take another shift left hash 2 comma R naught. Okay, that instruction performs shift left operation. Okay, that instruction shift the bits of R naught to the left by the number of times specified in the instruction. So the number of times nothing but 2. Okay, so that instruction performs a shift operation on the content of R naught by number 2. So that instruction performs 2 times shift operation. Okay, let us take one example. Here the content of R naught is 01110, 011, okay, and so on. Okay, so left shift, logical shift left has to or not. Okay, so logical shift left has to or not. This is the example given in textbook. Okay, so let us see. First, content of R naught will be shifted to carry flag. Okay, one by one. Content of R naught is binary bits. Each bit will be shifted to carry flag and then dropped. Whatever the vacated places will be filled with zeros. Now let us see how it will perform left shift operation. Example, initially carry flag is 0. Before going to perform shift operation, our example is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, dot, dot, 0, 1, 1. Okay, now perform shift operation by 1. Okay, so this 0 will be shifted to carry flag. This 1 will be shifted to vacated position, MSB bit. Okay, so now this 1 will be shifted to left. Okay, again shifted to left. This is shifted to left and so on. 1, 1. Okay, then here automatically this vacated position will be filled with 0. Okay, zeros will be inserted. Okay, now this is one time shift operation. Our example is two time. Okay, L shift left 02, hash 02 comma R naught. Our example is L shift left hash 2 comma R naught. Okay, now shift left, perform another shift operation. Okay, so one will be shifted to carry flag. This one will be shifted to vacated position 1, MSB bit position. Okay, next 1, next 0, and so on. 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay, automatically last vacated position will be filled with 0. Okay, so now after performing two times shift operations, output is 1. Okay, next 110 0110. Okay, this is the output. Okay, after performing the example L shift left has to comma R naught. Okay, after performing that operation, we'll get the output. Again, that output will be stored in R naught only. Okay, like that processor performs shift operation when use that instruction. Okay, here it performs two times shift operation. Okay, perform shift left the bits of R naught. Okay, then after shift operation, output will be stored in destination register, that is R naught. Now let us see shift right operation. Okay, so the syntax for this logic shift right count comma destination. Okay, so here count may be immediate value or that can be specified in the register. Logical shift right count comma destination. Okay, example, logical shift right count is hash 2 comma destination register is R naught. Okay, so let us take here R naught having the content, the binary bits, those bits will be shifted to right. Okay, those bits will be shifted to carry flag and then dropped. Okay, so whatever the vacated position will be filled with zeros. Okay, now let us see this example. 0, 1, 1, 0, dot, 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 0, 1, 1. Okay, so initially carry flag is 0. Before going to perform, this is carry flag. Okay, so carry flag bit is 0. Okay, now shift right, perform shift right operation. Okay, so this bit will be shifted to carry flag. This bit will be shifted to LSB bit position. This is MSB bit position. Okay, this bit will be shifted to vacated LSB bit position. That is 1, 0 will be shifted like this. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay, last vacated position will be filled with 0. Okay, now perform. This is one time shift operation, right shift operation. Now perform another time, because our count is 2 times shift operation. Okay, now this one will be shifted to carry flag. Next 0, 0, 1 will be shifted to this 1, 1, and then 0 will be shifted to this. Next this 0 will be shifted, whatever the vacated position will be filled with 0. Okay, now answer is, output is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, finally 0. Okay, so carry flag content is 1. Okay, so now we got the output. That output is stored in R0. Okay, like that shift operations are performed. Okay, so this logic shift write instruction is used to perform shift the bits of R0 write by the number of times specified in the count, and then after performing shift operation, output will be stored in destination register R0. Okay, in this case of shift, just I want to say one point. Left shift, for example 0, 0, 1, 0, this is 0, 2, perform logical shift left. Okay, so here left shift, nothing but 0, 0, 1 will be shifted to this 0, automatically 0 will be inserted. Okay, so now this number is 4. Here in this case, if you use a left shift operation, that 2 will be multiplied with 2. Okay, the output you will get 0, 4 in case of left shift operation. Okay, now in case of right shift operation, for example if you take 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, that is 0, 4. Okay, if you shift right, okay, this goes to carry flag. Okay, 0, 1, 0, okay, automatically 0 will be inserted. Okay, okay, now the content is 0, 2. It performs the number divided by 2, then you'll get coefficient 2. Okay, so left shift operation is used to perform multiplication by 2 operation. Right shift operation is used to perform divide by 2 operation. Okay, now let us see different types of shift operation: logical shift and arithmetic shift. Okay, in arithmetic shift we have 2 kinds of instructions. Those are arithmetic shift left and arithmetic shift right. Okay, so arithmetic shift left is same as logical shift left. Okay, in case of arithmetic shift right, arithmetic shift right is used to preserve the sign bit also after performing shift operation. Okay, for example syntax is arithmetic shift right count comma destination. Okay, this instruction performs the shift operation, that is this instruction shift the content of destination bits to the right by the number of times specified in the count. This is the content of R0. Okay, it will be shifted to right, that means first bit will be shifted to carry flag. Okay, then last bit, whatever the sign bit, either 0 or 1, okay, that will remains same. Now let us see, for example 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, ... 0, 1, 0. Okay, initially carry flag is 0. Okay, carry flag, is 0. Okay, now perform right operation, right shift operation. 1, 0, this bit will be moved to carry flag. Okay, dot dot. Okay, 1, this bit will be moved to this 0, 0, 1. Okay, so whatever the MSB bit will remain same. Okay, next, this is one time operation, but our example is arithmetic shift right has to come or not. Okay, so we have to perform arithmetic shift 2 times. Okay, now let us perform another time. 1 will be shifted to carry flag and then 0 will be shifted right. 1 1 0 0 1, this one will be shifted and here the MSB bit will remain same. Okay, now the output is 1 1 1 0 0 1 1. Okay, 1 1 1 0 0 1 1. Okay, last bit is 0, last bit is 0, carry flag is 1 after performing arithmetic shift right by 2 times. Okay, so this is used in case of 2's complement operation. Okay, to preserve the negative sign of that number. Okay, so this MSB bit is the MSB bit indicates sign of this number. Okay, so if the that bit is 0, then we can say positive number, 1 we can say negative number, so it remains same. Okay, here our MSB bit is 1, that means negative number. Okay, so the sign will remain same. Okay, sign will remain same. Okay, let us move on to rotate instruction. Here rotate instruction, in case of shift operation we lost some bits. Okay, so those bits will be shifted to carry flag and then dropped. Okay, that bits may be lost. Okay, so to avoid that, okay, we can go for rotate instruction. Okay, so in this case we have rotate left, rotate right, rotate left with carry, rotate left without carry. Different types of operations are there. Okay, under rotate instructions. Now let us see rotate left. Our example is rotate left has to comma or not. Rotate left has to comma or not. Okay, so or not, first or not content will be shifted left to the carry flag, then whatever the carry flag bit will be shifted to the vacated position of the R naught. Okay, now let us see with example. Okay, for example, carry flag before performing rotate operation, carry flag contains 0, then here we have 0. In our example we have 0 1 1 0 dot dot 0 1 1. Okay, now rotate left. Okay, perform left operation, left shift operation first. Okay, so first bit will be moved to MSB bit position, that means 1 1 1, this bit will be moved to this place dot dot. Okay, next 0 1 1, so this MSB bit will be shifted to carry flag. Okay, so this carry flag bit will be shifted to vacated position, that is LSB bit position. Okay, so whatever the carry flag contains default value, that may be neglected. In this case, rotate without carry. Okay, rotate left without carry. Okay, now our example is to perform rotate operation by 2 times. Perform rotate operation another time. Okay, now first MSB bit will be shifted to carry flag, then the vacated MSB bit will be filled with the next bit 1 0 dot dot here 0 will be shifted to left, 1 1, this 0 will be shifted to vacated position. In this case carry flag will be shifted, that is 1. Okay, now after performing rotate left operation by 2 times, the output is carry flag is 1 and 110 110 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, so that is the final output that will be stored in R0 only. Entire content will be stored in R0 only, because the R0 is the destination register according to that syntax. Now let us concentrate on rotate left with carry. Okay, so rotate left with carry, perform left shift operation first. Okay, then you need to consider carry flag. Without carry we neglect the carry flag. Now in this case we have to consider carry. Okay, so let us see example. Here content of R0 will be shifted to carry flag, then carry flag will be shifted to the vacated position. Okay, now in case of rotate left instruction, first initially carry flag content is 0. Okay, now R0 content is 0 1 1 1 0 dot dot 0 1 1. Okay, rotate left with carry. Now we have to consider carry flag bit. Okay, so now if this is MSB bit and this is LSB bit. Okay, 0 will be shifted to carry flag. Okay, now this bit will be shifted to vacated MSB bit position, then shifted all the bits likewise, 0 dot dot 0 1 1. This carry flag will be shifted to the vacated LSB bit position. Okay, so this is the initial content of carry flag, or we can say default carry. Okay, before performing this rotate left operation. Okay, this is one time rotate operation. Now perform another time rotate left. Okay, this will be moved to carry flag, this will be moved to vacated MSB bit position, 1 0 dot dot 0 1 1 and then 0. Okay, this vacated position will be filled with this 0. Okay, so now the output of R0 is 110 0 1 1 0 0. See, 110 0 1 1 0 0. Okay, now after performing rotate left through carry operation, carry flag output is 1. Okay, likewise rotate left through carry operation is performed with the help of that instruction, rotate left through carry. Next, likewise rotate right without carry, rotate right with carry operations can also be performed. In this case the syntax is rotate right has to comma R0. That instruction performs the rotate right operation on the content of R0 by the number of times specified in the instruction, that is 2. Okay, so rotate right has to comma R0. Okay, now what is R0 content here? See, so rotate right. Okay, rotate right, it perform right shift operation first. Okay, then rotate the carry flag to the vacated position. Okay, so first initially 0 1 1 1 is example I am taking, 0 dot dot 0, rotate right. Carry flag will be in right side. Okay, initially carry flag is 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay, so 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, now rotate right without carry. Rotate right without carry. This instruction is without carry. Without carry. Okay, now rotate right operation performs right shift first. One is moved to carry flag, then this one will be moved to this. Next 0 dot dot 0 1 next 1 next 1 next 0 then this vacated position will be filled with the carry flag, that is 1. Okay, now here we are neglecting whatever the previous carry flag content. Okay, now again perform rotate operation another time. Okay, now carry flag will be filled with the LSB bit. Now 0 is moved to right side, dot dot 0 1, this 1 will be shifted to 1 0, this 1 will be filled with shifted to right. Okay, then this carry flag will be shifted to MSB bit position, that is 1. Okay, so the output is 110110. Okay, 110110. Okay, last bit is LSB bit is 0. Okay, LSB bit is 0, carry flag bit is 1. Okay, likewise rotate right operation is performed. Now let us concentrate on rotate right through carry. Okay, we have to consider carry flag. In previous without carry we neglect that carry flag, whatever the default value. In this case we consider carry flag. Okay, for example 0 1 1 0 dot dot 0 1 1. Carry flag is initially 0. Okay, now perform shift right operation. Okay, so this will be moved to carry flag 1, this will be moved to LSB bit position, dot dot 0 1 1 1, this 0 will be shifted to this. Okay, in this case with carry. Okay, we are discussing about rotate right through carry, so we have to consider our carry flag. This will be shifted to the vacated MSB bit position. So now this is one time rotate right through carry. We have to perform rotate right through carry by two times. In our example is two time rotate right through carry operation. Okay, so now this will be moved to carry flag, next 0 dot dot 0 1 1 1 0 0. Okay, so this previous whatever the previous carry will be shifted to the vacated position. Okay, now the output is 1 0 0 1 1 1 0, this is 0. Okay, now carry flag is 1. Okay, likewise rotate right through carry operation is performed with the help of this instruction. Okay, so here count is has to, destination is R naught, the output will be stored in R naught. Likewise rotate instructions are performed. Okay, next in previous video we have discussed about arithmetic instruction, add, sub instruction. In this case we will discuss about multiply and divide instructions. Multiply instruction is used to perform multiplication operation between source operand and destination operand. Okay, after performing the output will be stored in destination register RJ. Okay, RI is the source, RJ is the destination register. Okay, so for example RI is 8 bit data. RA contains 8-bit data. RJ contains 8-bit data. After performing multiplication operation, we will get 16-bit data. To save this output in RJ, okay, the output will be stored in destination RJ. Okay, but RJ capacity is 8-bit only. So in this case, 8 bits plus 8-bit. Okay, so lower order 8 bits will be stored in RJ, higher order 8 bits will be stored in RJ plus 1. Okay, so likewise in this case, higher order half bits will be stored in RJ plus 1. Okay, now in the case of division operation, source operand and destination operand, output will be stored in destination. Okay, RJ contains coefficient. After performing division operation, output will be stored in RJ, that is coefficient will be stored in RJ, and then remainder will be stored in RJ plus 1 register. Let us summarize the topic. Till now we have discussed about different types of logic instructions and shift instructions. In shift instructions, we have different types of instructions. Those are logic shift and arithmetic shift. Under logic shift, we have logic left shift, logic right shift. Under arithmetic shift right and arithmetic shift left instructions we have discussed. And also under rotate instructions, we have different kinds of rotate instructions we have discussed. Those are rotate left, rotate right without carry, and rotate left, rotate right with carry. Okay. Let us move on to the questionnaire slide. So here R0 is given. Find what is the output of R0 after performing logic shift left hash 1 comma R0 operation. Okay. Next, what is the 2's complement of 0011? Next question, here R0 is given. What is the output of R0 after performing rotate right through carry hash 2 comma R0 operation? Thank you. We will meet in the next video.